What's going on? Welcome to today's video. In today's video, we're going through a shoulder workout, and we're also going through the second part of a Q&A that I did like 2 weeks ago. Went and visited home being West Virginia, for Thanksgiving. My parents' 33rd anniversary. Shout out to the homies Ed and Linda for being married for a goddamn long time and showing his true love still exists, and my brother and his beautiful wife, Emily, and his two sons, Vincent and Nathan. And they had their third anniversary. So lots of good things, great visit home. Let's get into the video. Baby, I'm sorry. I'm not sorry. Baby, I'm sorry. All right, guys, so before we go into the workout, I'm gonna do a physique update. So today is Saturday, so 2 days after Thanksgiving. Ate a crap ton on Thanksgiving, probably at least 6,000 calories worth of food. And then yesterday I went low carb, high protein. So low carb for me, you know, it was about 100 grams of carbs, and high protein fat was kind of whatever. I think it was like 70 or 80 grams yesterday. I'll have it on the screen. Either way, right now the physique you're looking at sitting at about 197, 198, which is a great weight for me. My body naturally likes sitting between 205 and 210. So this is just a natural increase by increasing calories after my competition phase, which last competition was about 4 weeks ago, 4 or 5 weeks ago. And I'm in a really good place, honestly. This diet so far has been wonderful, and maintaining some leanness. Something just clanging to that. Yeah. Okay. What age did you start hustling? Or how many years has it been since? Man, I've been hustling since I was born, that's all I gotta say. Have you ever considered CrossFit? I've taken CrossFit many different times. I like CrossFit, I think it's dope. Very challenging, cardiovascular endurance, muscular endurance. There was this one CrossFit workout I did where it was deadlift. It was deadlift, run 400 meters, come back, deadlift, increase the weight, deadlift, run 400 meters. I think it was sets of 12. Sets of 12, deadlift. In between sets, we did 5 sets running 400 meters. Yo. No. Yes, I actually do fucking in a sick way enjoy that shit, but damn. So guys, first exercise is going to be shoulder press, seated, overhead press. And what we're doing is 4 sets here, and we are starting heavy and then decreasing in load and increasing in reps as we move through the sets. First movement, time to bring the energy, bring the intensity, bring the power. You're fresh, you've warmed up, get it. Of your clients, would you say are 50 plus? Do I see them competing? So of my client pool, if I can give an estimate, I would say around 20% are 50 plus, and I do not coach competitors, okay? I coach everyday individuals, so to speak, gen pop, that is just looking to lose fat, gain muscle. It's not to say in the future I won't coach competitors, but as of right now, it doesn't make sense for me. Hi, if you had to give up one, coffee or peanut butter, coffee, because I can get caffeine elsewhere. How many grams of protein per kilogram of body weight do I eat? I believe it works out to like 2.5, 2.6. How many grams of, already answered that. How do you afford all these dope clothes? A lot of the gym wear that I wear is from a company called Young LA. I was a customer of theirs, buying their stuff, enjoyed it, messaged them, said, hey, can I promote your stuff? They said yes, they sent me more clothes. Bada bing, bada boom, I have 15% discount code. Intention of answering that wasn't to shower a code on you guys, but that's kind of how, for now. Is there a 3-day split? Is the 3-day split a good routine to stick to for a long time or switch it up? So you may be doing full body workouts, you may be doing push-pull legs. You can stick to it. Depends if you're still enjoying it though, right? And if you're not enjoying it, it's getting a little bit monotonous. I think there's a time where we should stick to it regardless, like a 12-week period at least, 3 months. And then if it's becoming monotonous, then you can switch things up. All right, my people, next exercise. Number 2 is Arnold press, continuing with the front delt, medial delt work, upper chest work in general, tricep work. Arnold press, higher in reps, knocking out 3 sets here, and we're supersetting that with the next movement.
Why do we need to drink so much water when taking creatine? Where do people get this belief you have to drink so much water? It's like, oh my God, I'm taking creatine, I've gotta like triple my water intake. No, it's not the case. You can drink like, drink like 12 more ounces of water a day. That's barely noticeable. It's not true. I want to increase muscle mass, how can I do cardio? You can do cardio for cardiovascular health, you just gotta be sure that you're eating enough, you're eating in a caloric surplus. Eat more calories than your body requires to stay the same weight. Brian, does your coaching include macro coaching? Yes, a lot of it. Would I marry you? Do you like peanut butter? Do you treat people good who can do nothing for you? Do you have a big butt? Those three, my criteria. How sexy are you? Extremely. Trying to shed fat. Is a low carb, moderate fat and high protein a good start? Sure. Yes, you can do that, definitely. You can go low carb. You can also just reduce your calories and keep the macro ratios pretty much the same. Guys, carbs like fuel our workouts, right? You know, you don't have to go super low carb. Just make sure you're in a negative energy balance for the day. Need new daytime shorts because you made my legs too big. Help me. I will link. I have these stretchy shorts. I can't think of them off the top of my head. It's either Topman or Bonobos. I'll link the ones that I wear in the description. Next movement, number three, single rear delt fly, single dumbbell rear delt fly. Something for me that is challenging is not having my trap engage when I'm doing rear delt fly. So really paying attention to just feeling it in the muscle that's intended to work. Can't really speak right now. So that's the posterior delt. The rear delt, so something that I find helpful, especially doing single, because you have a free hand, is you can tap the muscle you're intending to work, which is you making a connection with your brain, like, yo, feel the tension, feel the work here, not here. Don't tap your trap, but just know that it's not a trap movement, which my body loves to make it a trap movement, so just be aware.
How do you find time to do everything in your day? So at this point, I'm grateful to have employees, and I get things done myself because I don't focus on a lot of shit. Do I feel lonely? Not at all. I'm a college student, question, what should I be eating? College student, so when I was in college, I was eating a lot of Subway, I was eating a lot of Qdoba. Qdoba's like Chipotle, but West Virginia didn't have Chipotle at the time. And then at the store, I just, you know, I would think protein source, carb source, fat source. Through college, I was consistently training, so I understood nutrition at that point. Yo, if you buy bags of chicken, if you buy bags of rice, if you buy veggies in bulk, like frozen veggies, there's usually like a 10 for 10 deal, something like that. It's not very expensive. I don't know where people get this thought. People love to create reasons why things are hard to do and find evidence to support it. Yeah, it's not extremely expensive to eat healthy. I don't care what someone says. It simply is not. I'm trying to get a lean body. Thighs and ass are too big. It's a great problem. So trying to do cardio. Yes, you can do cardio. You can do cardio. I always say lead with nutrition first and weight training. Firm believer, and I know it to be true for myself. Like, I got down to very shredded without doing cardio. And then I introduced cardio as it was necessary. So cardio is like step three, step four in the process, but yes, you can do cardio. What is 12 drop 12? So that's referring to a drop set. So you do 12 reps, you immediately grab a lighter weight, 25% or so percent lower than the weight that you were using. Idea there is I can still continue to perform reps just at a lighter weight, and then you do another 12 reps. Would you rather pee a marble or poop a softball? Oh my God. So I'd say solid objects are used to coming out back there. So I think it'd be a little less painful. Like, I have a buddy named Chris, I won't say his last name, but he had kidney stones when we were growing up, and he struggled with that shit, and I'm like, yo, fuck that sucks. I don't wanna experience that. What age did you start training? 17? Body fat percentage right now after competition, I'm probably like 7-8%, kinda doing a pseudo reverse diet.
Next order of business is going to be standing dumbbell push press. So, this one is something I don't do often, but this is really with the intention of exhausting the shoulders, the front delts, the medial delts, compound movement, you're getting some core engagement, you're getting some leg engagement, stability all around. And this one will give you a run for your money. All right, we've got three sets here that we're moving on to some isolation work to finish up.
How many times a day do you train? How many times a day can you train? Depends on the intensity. You know, are we training, are we talking like three sets of push-ups? If so, probably train like five times a day. If it's gonna be intense stuff, probably once. If it's gonna be moderate, maybe twice. Do I speak Spanish? No. What's your ethnicity? Portuguese and Italian. How do you gain size? Eat more, train hard. Ever lack confidence? Yes, 100%. How do you overcome it? If you ever did, how did you overcome it? Be hard, be hard for us to find a human being who's not experienced lack of confidence in their life. I think I had this false belief when I was younger that external achievements were going to give me confidence, but you kind of realize over time that the joke's on you. It's really from internal achievements, guarding your word, doing what you say you're gonna do. Guys, nothing affects confidence more than not doing things you say you're going to do or being a liar. That affects your confidence royally. And it's just a sign of immediate, immense, intense self-disrespect, lack of self-respect. So once you dial in on your relationship with yourself, I know this is very general, but you'll improve your confidence quite a bit. Stop taking creatine, intake swag muscles. What the fuck are swag muscles? That right there, huh? All right. This is what we're gonna wrap up with. So we've got two movements to wrap up on the cables. We're gonna superset these. We've got lateral delt, medial delt, lateral raise on the cables. Superset that with front raise, single. And we're going no rest. Well, you rest after the front delt work, the front raise. 60 seconds, then we go right back into the lateral raises. Three sets, kill it. And this is gonna be a killer shoulder workout. Delt workout for you. Take this one to the bank if you're ready to grow.
Following you a year and a half now, I've lost almost 70 pounds. Dude, that's so sick. Congratulations. Yo, that fucking lights me up, man. Fucking cheers to that. Where are you from? I was born in Dallas, moved to Virginia, moved to Massachusetts, moved to West Virginia, moved to Washington, D.C., moved to L.A. And depending on who asks, I say I'm from a different place, but I spent the majority of my years in first Massachusetts in Medway, Massachusetts outside of Boston, until middle school. And then middle school, I moved to West Virginia, Morgantown, West Virginia. It's like 2-3 hours west of Washington, D.C. And stayed in West Virginia through college, went to West Virginia University, at which time I moved to Washington, D.C. So honestly, when people ask me in Los Angeles, like, where are you from? I usually say Washington, D.C., actually. Do I work out 7 times a week? No. What's my major income activity? Coaching. So I have, and I actually added it up when I screenshotted this in my head. I have 7 sources of income. Money Master of the Game, Tony Robbins, in that book talks about having average millionaire has at least 7 sources of income. So I've worked over the last several years to get to that point. I'm owner/partner in 3 of those sources. 4 of them are more so just engagements with different companies, with promotions and things like that, not just fitness. And but it's as of right now, it's coaching.
So guys, with this Q&A that I'm going through, I know I answered a question about money and talking about revenue streams and whatnot. And I do want to be clear, none of this came naturally to me. I'm more, you know, I did go to school for business, so I have an accounting degree, a finance degree, I've mentioned that a lot. But I'm not naturally a logic brain thinker, a business mind. I'm totally not a naturally born entrepreneur. Like, everything I've learned has been learned from someone else. Like, whether I've invested in a mentor or I've watched a shit ton of YouTube videos or elsewhere, I think something that I do is I tend to speak in like a nonchalant way, like, oh yeah, like, of course I have different revenue streams. Where when I was first starting, if I heard someone say that, I'd be like, how the fuck do you do that? So if you're watching this, like, where do you even begin? Please understand that, like, it's something that you're not gonna understand until you start taking action on the first one. And then you just kind of build over time, right? Because I don't want to go into preach mode, but it's, you jump off the cliff and build your wings on the way down. You don't have the perfect plan before you start taking action, right? So I've learned a lot along the way. I'm continuing to learn. My best advice to you is don't try to reinvent the wheel. Go to someone who's done it before you and be like, yo, can you teach me for free? And if they say no, be like, can I pay you to teach me? And that'll be your best bet, okay? So anyways, let's continue.
Before you start working out, were you skinny or fat? So I was on the chubbier side until about age 4 or 5. My natural body set point, I think it's a bit more on the chubby side, but I've honestly never been able to realize that because right around age 4 and 5, I started being active, very active. Sports, all the sports. Dad had having us doing every sport. So wants Brian to be on the Red Sox. I'm not sure if that's true, but I kind of think so. And did every sport except pretty much football and swimming. And then I've always been active. So I started lifting, to answer your question, in a skinny place. Why? Well, I was a cross country runner, I was a track runner, I was a soccer player. You know, some days I was running almost 20 miles. Wrap your head around that. How do you curb your appetite during meals? Get enough water, get enough protein. When you say that to someone who's not doing that, it's like, yeah, like, what else? No, like, are you getting enough fucking protein and water? No, you're not. Do it and then tell me how you feel. Seriously. I'm a vegetarian. I don't know why I just said it.
that way. I want to know the way to reduce the belly fat, eating in a caloric deficit. Last question, am I bisexual? I'm not bisexual. However, I don't have anything wrong with being bisexual. I just personally, knowing myself, have not been sexually attracted to a man. But yeah, so no, I would say no. But emotionally, I think like emotions and having deep connection to someone, I don't necessarily think that is different from male or female. Like, I have great relationships that I really look forward to, like engaging with like friends. Like my best friend, Matt, have a great relationship with Matt. Love hanging out with him. But so is that bisexual or is it strictly sexual? You know, what's the definition here? Y'all know I moved to LA, right? We don't have like clear lines out here, okay?